Hello everyone, I'm Rebecca Keppel and I'm super excited to be here on the Pretty Pink Posh YouTube channel today. I have three shakers to share with you using the stocking shaker die. So to get started, these are the two dies that are inside this set. There's the stocking and a little Christmas tree. I'm starting with the stocking and cutting it out of white cardstock. We're going to build this shaker down into the card. So we will cut the shaker out of white fun foam as well, and that will be what is going to create the depth for those shaker goodies to swirl around. So I cut the fun foam just a little bit smaller than the cardstock, and now I have a piece of acetate that I'm cutting into an A2 size so that I can create a shaker window. So the white cardstock will get some adhesive behind it, and that will get placed down onto the acetate to create the shaker window. And for this, you can use tape runner, you can use whatever kind of adhesive you want. So I'm placing the cutout stocking onto the acetate to create that window effect. Now I'll take the fun foam that I cut a little bit smaller, and the reason that I cut it a little bit smaller is so I can line up the two and it won't be that difficult for me. So you don't have to match exactly where you're cutting it out if you just trim it down a little bit. Then for the red frame, I'll put that right on top of the acetate just so that you can see more of the shape of the stocking, which is so cute. Then I've also cut out the Christmas tree out of green cardstock, and we'll use some of the adorable Christmas cookie shaker beads inside. So we're working on the back of the card here and pouring those shaker goodies into the open area. The acetate is keeping them inside. Now we'll put a little bit of liquid adhesive all around the stocking. We want to make sure that the fun foam adheres to the cardstock in the back with no gaps in between so that none of those beads come out. So a little bit all around the A2 piece of fun foam that's a little bit smaller than A2, and then a definite ring around the entire stocking. Then I'll line up a piece of A2 cardstock on the back and then flip it over, and you can see all those cute little shaker beads inside moving around. The shaker beads move so smoothly inside a shaker card, so if you're used to other things like sequins, I recommend trying these beads because they really just roll around so quickly inside a shaker card. They make them very fun. I'll use some of the Candy Cane Lane clay confetti as accents on my card. I decorated the little Christmas tree with it, and I added a few snowflakes at the top of the stocking. And last, I'll add some white gel pen details all around the stocking. I love the look of the red and white of the snowflakes and those little white gel pen details. Now I have a Merry Christmas foil design. I used the Merry Christmas foil plates from Pretty Pink Posh and the shadow dies to cut them out. Last but not least, I decided to add a few green stars as well onto the card itself, and I'll just pick those up with an embellishment tool and place them down on a dot of glue. And that completes the first shaker card where we built it down into the card. Next, we're going to create a shaker card where we create a shaker shape and build it up off of the card. So I have a piece of glitter foam, and that is a gold glitter foam that I've cut out the frame of the stocking, and I'll place that down on acetate and let it dry. Now I have a piece of white fun foam that we cut out from the previous card, and I'll place that on an A2 piece of pink cardstock. So we're going to build this one up and create a shape shaker for it. So I decided I wanted a little more room in there, so I'm adding a second layer of white fun foam cut out with the same shaker die. And I'll just make sure again that I have a ring around the entire stocking that's going to trap those shaker goodies inside. I don't want them squeaking out of any holes. So now I have double ply of the white fun foam that gives me a little more room. I've used the Sentiment Strips, Holiday Sentiment Strips stamp set, and the Sentiment Strips dies here to cut out a cute little sentiment that says making spirits bright. Now that the gold fun foam is dry on the acetate, I will cut around there so that it is flush, the acetate is flush to that gold sparkle fun foam. And I'll add another round of adhesive on the white fun foam so that I can adhere this down. So look at all that dimension. This stocking is really popped up. I'll even add a little bit of liquid adhesive behind some foam tape that I placed on the sentiment because I was worried it wasn't going to adhere down to the glitter on top. I've cut the little Christmas tree out of white fun foam, so it's a little dimensional, and I'll add a few of those shaker goodies that we used inside on the Christmas trees to decorate them. And it's just such a fun, different color combination. It's so fun to play with those Christmas trees and to create a shaker card. For this shaker card, we're going to use the frame from the Pretty Pink Posh Fancy Cake die set. And that creates a stitched frame that you can put adhesive all around and then adhere it down to an A2 piece of acetate. So we'll be creating kind of an edge-to-edge shaker here. They're really easy, especially if it's a rectangle like this, because you can just place foam tape on all the edges of that frame. I have a thin foam tape here. I haven't had to cut it in half or anything. And then you can just pour the Christmas Magic shaker beads right in the well that you've created with your foam tape. Then peel off those back protective layers and again, line up a piece of cardstock that is A2. Here I'm using silver mirror cardstock in the background and for the frame as well. And check out those magic Christmas shaker beads. They look so pretty. So I've cut the stocking out of a dark and light green that I thought went well with the Christmas Magic shaker beads. So I'll use the dark as the outline, and then for the interior of the stocking, I'll place that light green there. So you can have both of these colors and you can see all those shaker goodies going round and round. I also cut the top out of white cardstock, and I'm just going to trim off those little edges that would have fell down so that I can create the cuff at the top of the stocking. I'm going to press it into some Versamark ink and pour some fine iridescent white glitter on top, and then lay some adhesive on the top of the green stocking so that I can place that glittery white cuff on top. I'm also placing a few dots of liquid glue right on top of the glittery cuff so that I can add a few dark green star embellishments on that. So everything just goes so well together. There are even some gold beads in the bead set. So I thought a gold glitter tree with some white snowflakes would really stand out and make this card special. And a warmest wishes sentiment strip with the flag sentiment strip die to finish it off. I hope you can see that with this one stocking die, you can create so many different types of shaker cards that are so much fun for somebody to receive. They absolutely make tons of noise and roll around and create such a fun impact. I want to thank you so much for stopping by today. Have a wonderful day.